Now, today we will see the meshing option. We will explore the meshing command. Now in geometry, we will import one assembly part and make meshing. Open it. In geometry, design modeler, there is a three part in the geometry. So we will mesh these three all part with a brick meshing. Brick meshing, let's see what is that with brick meshing. Import, generate. Now you can see the geometry. This is one wall geometry. There is a three distinct part as the. Our intention is to make this whole geometry uniformly meshed. So first of all, select the complicated part first, then explore the other part. So go in model section. Now you can see so there is a three part. So the part one is a most complicated part. So we will select first two mesh, make the other two and three part suppress. Right click, suppress body. Now you can see it is a cross mark, totally suppressed from the geometry. Now whatever we do the operation, it will apply only part one. First of all, check the dimension. Rotate it properly. So for checking the overall length, you are supposed to place it on the scale. So near about 200 mm length is there. So for that, now in mesh, go to sizing. Here in sizing, there is a third option, element size. Now default is 0. Now I will apply the size, element size, that is will apply to whole part. I will make it 4 mm. So the all the elements will become the size of 4 mm. Make it update. Now you can see. This is meshing of tetrahedron. Tetrahedron elements has been created. So before making 3 mm, if you are place the element size 0, let's see what happens. Now you can see the distribution of element. In quality, you can check from here. In quality, in mass metric, instead of none, select element quality. Now we can see the quality matrix. Near to 1 is a more reliable element are there. It is a distribution from 0 to 1. Now we will increase the size from sizing element size from default 0 to 4 mm, and then we will observe the mass matrix. Update. Now we have shifted toward one side, 0 to 1. So the element quality has improved, because ultimately results depend on massing. After doing this, one is supposed to check the each and every section. So minimum 2 elements should be there. Here only 1 element. So we want supposed to increase the element. Here you can see it is a 1 element. So for that, mesh, right click, insert. Here there is a lot of options are there. We use the face meshing option. In face meshing, we will increase the mesh element. Click on face meshing. Select the faces. Select the face where the similar dimensions are there, similar geometries are there. Control click and select. Apply. Now here you can see internal number of division. Instead of 0, make it 2. The 2 elements generated at the side. Now update. For reflect, make update. Now you can see minimum 2 element has created. Now let's see the other part. Let's focus on this side. Face sizing. Now make it update. Now we will use face meshing for other purpose, like distribute the element uniformly throughout. Like you can see in whole section, there is a not properly uniform distributions are there. Now we will make it uniform distributed. Face meshing. Control click and select the faces. Similar size faces one supposed to select. Now apply. Update. Now we can see the uniform distribution. Let's check other part. Here you can see. Here you can see. Same way, if you want to make it uniform distribution over here, hole in holes part. There is a lot of holes are there. Selection is very tough, so there is a one more method. Geometry. Select the hole of one side, right click. Create name selection. Provide the name. Write the hole, then here second option, apply geometry item of the same. Click on size. So whatever the same size elements or features are there, they all will be selected. Now in name selection, click on hole. Now you can see all hole elements has been selected. Now we will make the meshing. Face meshing. Now instead of geometry selection, name selection. Now select the name holes. Operate. Check. Now you can see it is uniformly arranged element. So after completion, one has to check the distribution of element. Here you can see the improper distribution of element. Let's correct it. For that, now next check the distribution of the mass. Here you can see it is an improper distribution. So make it correct. Let's use the different tools for that. Mesh, right click, insert. Now there is a here there is an improper distribution of mass. Let's correct it by using the tools pinch. Mass insert, right click, click on pinch. Here there is a master geometry and slave geometry. Whatever you want to follow, select first and then select the slave that will follow the master. Here you can see this line is come throughout, so this will become your master. Let's select. let's check in detail. Slave geometry, and this is supposed to select here. Apply, so 2H selected. See one line. Right, this is our master geometry. Now slave geometry. Slave geometry. Now there is a tolerance. We'll provide the fireman tolerance. So what are the in range of that surrounding? They will march. Now update. Just observe this area. Now you can see the difference. Let's check other part of the geometry.
Kya should be missing curve jo hai.
Let's check other part. We supposed to check the distribution of the element. Again, you can see here there is a problematic distribution. Here you can see the improper distribution of the mass. Let's check it. Now you can see the point is not necessary. So let's solve this point by using the same pinch method. Here the master geometry, it will become here master point. This is a master point, apply, now slave point, this and this, apply. Now the tolerance verify. Now again we can also solve it over here. Then use pinch. This is master slave 1, 2 and 3. Apply. Now make it update. So after updation you will get the different distribution of the mass. Now you can see the difference. Now it is properly distributed. Same way you are supposed to check each and every part. Like here. You can see that's again solid bench. Now same way we'll select the point. This is a master because it is a continuous line, and this is a slave. Same way on other side. Now make it update. So it is now distribution is popped. Check the other area. Still here. Problem. Now it is uniformly distributed. So this way you can improve your quality of mesh. Our purpose is to convert this tetrahedron mesh to brick mesh. Hexahedral, that means. For that, right click, insert, method. Here only geometrical selections are there. So select the whole geometry. Apply. Now there is a method is there. First by default only automatic. Instead of automatic, I'll make it hex dominant. In hex dominant, then update. Here it will convert this tetrahedron to brick meshes or hexahedral. It will take some time because the conversion itself it is complicated, so it will take time. It is only possible your elements are evenly distributed, so it become easy to conversion from tetrahedron to hex element. take time to convert it. Now you can see the mass. This is a good mass because there is always higher accuracy hexadrial mass. If you understand the mathematics behind this, you have to understand the FEM subjects, and that there is a whole discussion regarding element wise. In that, shape functions are different. Here it is a shape function is non-linear, so the transfer function, there is a, results are transferred very accurately compared to tetrahedron. It is a nice look, it's look nice, but here you can see if you are here, you can see some triangular elements are there. It is actually prism elements, but we permit it. You can see that here free mass, free face mass type, chord or triangle. The reason behind that, we will provide the flexibility. So there is no any more distortion in that. Now only one part we have meshed. Now it's time to go for second and third. Unsuppressed body. Now you can see only one part has been meshed. Now we require to mesh two other part. So for that, mesh right click method. Now select the two other part, apply. Now in method, go to multi zone. In multi zone, map mesh hexadominant. Only change required is just element size. We provide the size of the first part is a 4 mm. So same way we are providing 4 mm. The reason behind that we will see after meshing is completed. Now update it. It will take time. As per your processing speed, it will take time. Now you can see one error has encountered. Sometimes this happen, only one part has been messed. So for that, you supposed to provide separately. Now press again, go to method, select the third part, apply. Now hex dominant, update. will take time convert. Now you can see. Now you can see the brick mesh. We have provided the same element length for the part 2. So the reason is you can see the smooth connection between two. So this is the reason behind that, to provide the same element size. Now this is the ideal meshing condition. At the time of analysis, it will give good result. So that's it. Now let's see one more tool for that. Let's hide. See one option like that is inflation. The inflation is used where boundary effect required to capture. First geometry, select the whole geometry, apply, then boundary. In this boundary, where you want to create inflation. Inflation means it will create inflation layer. If I want to create inflation layer on this side, you have to select the boundary that is attached to it face. Like I want to create inflation on this side, so I have to select this face. So let's, I want to create inflation on this side, so I have to select this face. Let's select it. Select all the internal side. Now apply. Now, after that, there is a here layer. Number of layer you require to generate. Here there is a 5 layers are there. Related to 6 layer. Then growth rate. Growth rate is used to increase the thickness of the successive layer. Here is a by default 1.2, so it will increase the 20% in each stage, each layer wise 1.2. so make it update. Now you can see the layer. Generally it is used to capture the boundary effect, force or whatever, particularly assembly where both the faces are attached to it. You can see. Let's zoom that area. Here there is a 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And 1.2 times 20% it will increase the thickness. So this is a one more meshing option, that is a inflation. We will explore other option in the next video. Thank you.